Hey, what's happening, everybody? This is Rob of Rule of Two Review. Welcome back to the channel. And today I want to discuss everybody's favorite topic, Nintendo Directs. And most specifically, I want to talk about the next potential Nintendo Direct. And it's not because there's any sort of real significant rumors or leaks or discussions out there happening. In many ways, this is just kind of a thought in my own head as far as what Nintendo might be doing between now and their glorious return to E3 in June, and if a Nintendo Direct could be part of that plan. Before I jump any deeper into this Nintendo Direct topic, I do want to remind you guys that I am always trying to grow the channel here. I upload and post several videos every single week, and I tend to live stream at least once a week. I cover all things Nintendo and Metroid and all things gaming, so as you watch this video, if you seem to like what I'm doing and what you hear, then hopefully you will consider subscribing to the channel. So like I said, the purpose of this conversation is to discuss what the odds are of Nintendo giving us another Nintendo Direct or some sort of other big info dump or a presentation, maybe within the anniversary category, that they might actually do between now and E3, which of course, as we all know, and as I even talked about on a recent video, the ESA did finally confirm that E3 will be returning this year in 2021 after taking last year off because of the stupid pandemic that just ruined everything for everybody. And alongside of that news of E3 returning was the fact that Nintendo was one of the major companies that will be playing a part in the show. And this is exciting for all of the obvious reasons that we all know, and like I said, I even made a video discussing all the exciting possibilities about that. One of the things we know that they might be doing, and probably will be doing, is some kind of Nintendo Direct-type presentation for E3, or a digital event presentation, stuff that they usually do for the show. They've already had that as a part of their business strategy for E3 for many, many years, so why wouldn't they do the same thing again this year when E3 is already entirely digital? Now, it is important to note that after more than a year without a traditional Nintendo Direct, we did finally get that Nintendo Direct, the return of the show, in February of this year, so just a couple of weeks ago. And then even earlier this week, we actually got an Indie World presentation from Nintendo as well, detailing some new indie games that are going to be coming out over the next, really, the course of the next year or so. So we've seen Nintendo already start to dabble in this space. They're back to Nintendo Directs. They seem to be into giving us direct messaging, which is really great. But another Nintendo Direct between now and E3 could do wonders for their overall momentum and the overall hype for what they're doing. Now here's the thing, guys. If I was to give you my actual prediction, like an official prediction on if Nintendo will give us a Nintendo Direct between now and E3 in June, I would probably say overall, my guess would be still no, but that's only just barely do I think the answer is no. I obviously think there is a window of a chance that Nintendo would do this. And the main reason would be not only because it would just be smart and it would keep the massive momentum and hype for Nintendo and the Switch going into E3, where we expect the biggest reveals, but there's also a chance that Nintendo has so much planned to release this year or to reveal this year in terms of first party, third party, exclusive, whatever. They might have so much to show that it could be more than what would conveniently fit in an E3 Nintendo Direct. So maybe they have to kind of grease the wheels, so to speak, by getting some of the announcements out right before E3. Sure, there's a chance that it could be overload for them to give us a Nintendo Direct, like, you know, maybe next month in May, and then follow it up with a big one for E3 in June. Yeah, that seems like overkill, which is why, like I said, I'm overall suspecting that they probably won't be doing it. But when I think about the reasons that they could or how they might actually do it, I do still get excited, and there is that part of my brain that says, yeah, maybe Nintendo would be awesome enough to give us something before E3. And that could come in a couple of different packages, you guys. It could come in some kind of a regular Nintendo Direct. It could come in the form of a Nintendo Direct Mini. It could come in the form of another partner presentation, which is kind of, I guess, high on my list of possibilities, right? That maybe they would come back with a partner presentation between now and E3 where their biggest stuff is going to be revealed. It could even be one of those long fabled and theoried anniversary celebration presentations. What if they plan to do a Zelda 35th anniversary presentation before E3? And then at E3, maybe they would spend their time really focusing on blowing out Breath of the Wild 2. You know, something like that could be part of their plan. Of course, I'm also sitting over here in the corner waiting for a possible Metroid 35th anniversary celebration. I do still think there's a great chance we get that this year, and so that could also be something that they decide to do right before E3. Maybe they don't want to use E3 to celebrate the anniversaries. They might certainly talk about some of the games for these franchises, but maybe they don't want to celebrate the anniversaries at E3, so it makes more sense for them to get those celebrations and those initial announcements about the games out before E3, and then at E3, they can showcase, okay, here is what Wind Waker and Twilight Princess is going to look like and the changes we made for the Switch. Okay, here's the Metroid Prime Trilogy on the Switch. Let's do a Treehouse playthrough so you can see the upgraded graphics and we can show you some of the new bells and whistles. And of course, like I already said, Breath of the Wild 2. They would probably quickly discuss it in an anniversary presentation before E3, and then at E3, they spend a ton of time actually showing us and playing through the game. I know that nowadays, most people come to stuff like this looking for leaks or rumors or something from an official site and an official source, and I mean, here's the thing, you guys. That kind of stuff is always doing the rounds, okay? Many times publicly, many times behind the scenes, and I've definitely been privy to that stuff in the past. I'm not going to talk about what I may or may not be privy to right now, but the only thing I'll tell you when it comes to that, like the Nintendo Direct rumor and leak cycle, if you're paying attention at all to this space, then you know at any given time and any given day, that stuff is out there. You know, even if you go to the deepest, darkest corners of the internet and Reddit and Reset Era and Twitter, you're gonna find people talking about it and telling you that they know something, and so suddenly there's another story or a rumor about a Nintendo Direct. I'm not really trying to approach it from that angle today. This is really just about myself as a fan and a longtime Nintendo YouTuber who has been in the know about many things in the past, and I've had my mind blown for sure, and obviously still waiting on some things to potentially turn out to be real that I've heard in the past. But that's not what I'm doing today. Like I said, this is just, I'm a fan. I pay attention to this stuff. I love it just like you do. And when I think about the business model, I think about how exciting it could be if Nintendo had some sort of other presentation, Nintendo Direct or otherwise, to show us before E3. I think I speak for a lot of us when I say that many of us are maybe waiting for Nintendo to quote-unquote make up for lost ground from 2020 being so slow and weird. And keep in mind when I say that, I'm not trying to blame them or disparage them for having a weird or slow 2020. Many companies did. The pandemic changed everything, and Nintendo, you know, did what they could, or at least what they felt was the right thing to do within that time frame. But as we're here, kind of starting to come out of the end of the effects of all of that stuff, and we've already seen them bring back the traditional Nintendo Direct, we're seeing them come back to E3, I just think we're seeing more signs of life from Nintendo, and as I mentioned earlier in the video, we think about all these things and projects that we're waiting for and rumored and that we know they probably have to talk about. Metroid stuff, Zelda stuff, Bayonetta, more No More Heroes, the return of franchises like a Pikmin or an F-Zero, you know? I mean, all these different things that we think are probably going to be happening, not to mention the idea of new hardware. You guys, that could be something else. I almost forgot to bring that up. Maybe they even do a presentation that's solely about new Switch hardware, which I've been believing more and more, especially since these Bloomberg reports. If we remember, the Nintendo Switch Lite, I believe, was effectively revealed in its own little kind of presentation. And so maybe they do something for a Switch Pro or the, you know, a new super powerful upgrade Switch or a next gen, whatever the thing turns out to be, maybe they would do that as opposed to doing it at E3. All of these things, you can take all of these different ideas and concepts and presentation things, including E3, you can throw them into a pot and just shake that pot around, and it's like any one of these things could pop out at any time. I happen to think that they're going to have a great, huge direct showing at E3, and I'm about 55-45 on them doing a Nintendo Direct before E3. 55% of me thinks probably not, and they're going to save everything for E3. But 45% of me, which is a pretty significant chunk of my brain, right? 45% of me thinks that there is that chance. They're going to give us something else exciting to chew on between now and E3 in June. I mean, the month of May could be a prime time for something really cool like that. So either way, fingers crossed, this is how I see it. I think there's a little bit of a chance. And so with that being said, those are my thoughts and theories and guesses and predictions and discussions and all of that fun stuff. I, of course, want to hear what you have to say. I'm sure most of you probably feel like I do that there won't be a Nintendo Direct, but I'm hoping that we all want it so much that we're willing to at least keep our minds open for it. This isn't about being entitled. This isn't about necessarily expecting or getting mad at Nintendo if they don't do this, because that would not be fair to Nintendo. I'm just a guy putting an idea out there. I'm not trying to spread leaks and rumors. It's just a fan theory. And so we want it so much, let's get excited only at the possibility. Worst case scenario, they don't do it, but then they show up at E3 and they hopefully blow our minds. So this is what I think. Talk about your theories below. With that, this video is a wrap. Thanks, of course, as always, for tuning in, guys. This is Rob of Rule of Two Review, and I will catch you next time on another video.